Welcome to the third class of economics. Today we are going to do scarcity definitions of economics, which is given by economics Robbins. Okay, now first, what is scarcity definition? So economics is the science which studies human behavior as a relationship between ends and scarce means, which have alternative uses. So which means here the word comes scarce. Okay, scarce means your insufficiency of goods and commodity in compared to their demand. Okay, so and ends means human wants. Okay, so on this two topic, the Robbins has emphasized his definition. Okay, so this is your Robbins definition. Now we will do the main features of Robbins definitions. The first features we have is man has innumerable wants. It means that man has number of wants. Okay, by ends we know that human wants are unlimited. If we fulfill one wants, another wants immediately comes. Okay, then when we try to fulfill another wants, then the another wants will appear. So in this case, people wants to buy each and everything immediately one after another. It means that your human has, man has innumerable wants. Next we have, wants can be arranged in order of their importance. So what we can do, we know that as I already told you, human has innumerable wants, we have various wants, but wants can be graded according to their importance. How we can do that? If we have some important or urgent one that we can fulfill first, or the less important one we can give less priority. Okay, so in that way wants can be graded. People can grade their wants because we do not have lots of means to satisfy our wants. Okay, now the next features we have is your scarcity of means. The means refer here goods and commodities. We want every day we will go to the market, we want to buy each and everything. Okay, but the means to fulfill the money we have limited money we have to categorize according to their wants and according to their demand. Okay, so means refer here goods and commodities, and which are like people do all the hard working to earn money. Okay, isn't it? And we cannot blow that money, isn't it? So what we'll do, we know that we have scarcity of means, then what we can do, if means are abundant, then there won't be any economic problem. But we know that we have scarce means, we have scarcity of means. So in that case, what we can do, we can postpone our wants. Okay, now next features, the last features of your Robbins definitions of economics is here. Economics have alternative uses. The means have alternative uses. So alternate uses, like we know that I have already told you in my definitions, in Robbins definition, that people have various like wants, we have to grade it according to their importance. I have already told you. So last features, what the last feature says, we know that our means are limited, but the means can be used for a multiple purposes, isn't it? We can use that means for a multiple purposes. For example, land is a main important. Okay, nowadays the value of land is very high. Okay, so we have various uses of land. Okay, that's why that resources have alternate uses. Why? Like in the land we can construct building, we can make any schools, we can construct the offices. So in that way we have to use our means according to their necessities and all. So in that way, if we categorize our means, okay, if we grade it our means according to our needs, okay, then it will help us for the better life. Okay, so that is your scarcity definition of Robbins. Now without any criticism, okay, there weren't any definition, isn't it? So as I told you from the first class on the way, so like we have seen the definition given by Adam Smith, there was also criticized by other economists. Then we have the another definition given by Marshall, that was also criticized. This scarcity definition of Robbins is also not free from the criticism. Now what is the criticism? Okay, what is the criticism of Robbins definition? The first criticism we have is overemphasize on scarcity. Now overemphasize on scarcity is the Robbins definitions of economics has given unnecessary emphasis on scarcity. Okay, what does it mean that the problem in economics, the problem does not arises only because of scarcity of goods and commodity. Okay, so in this case we can take the example of Great Depression in USA in the year 1930s. Okay, the Great Depression of economics, that was in the year 1930s. Okay, so that was not because of your scarcity of commodity, that was here because of overproduction and abundant goods and commodity. There was a problem of economics. Okay, so the first criticism is your overemphasis on scarcity. In economics, in country, there will be problem not because of scarcity but because of overproduction and misutilization of goods and commodity. Also, the good example is your raw, like the Great Depression of your 1930s in USA. Okay, that was the first critique of Robin's definitions. Okay, the second critique of Robin's definition is according to your Professor Maurice. Okay, this definition, the scarcity definition, is not fit for the socialist economy. Now, what is socialist economy means? Socialist economy, like in socialist economy, most of the like decisions are taken by government for the betterment of the life of the people. Okay, so for that reason, your Robin's definition of scarcity is not fit for your socialist economy, because government take all the initiatives for supplying all the basic necessities, goods and commodities. Okay, now next we have not fit for rich country. So we know that there are developed and underdeveloped or developing economy, we know that, and the Robin's definition is not fit for your rich country. Why? Because rich country, they don't have any problem of their resources. In the rich or in the sound economy, they don't have any problem regarding their resources because they have plenty of resources. Okay, the problem of like resources only we have in the underdeveloped economy and all. That is the reason why this scarcity definition is not fit for your rich country and all. Understood? So thank you very much. This is for today. Okay, we'll continue with another definition in my next class. Okay, thank you, students.